Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Rolling Solo. My name is Adam Smith, and today I hope this might be, maybe, the finale, and we'll hope that our 50-50 gamble on which objective token to go after ends up panning out the way we want it to. So here goes. In the last video, we got the two cards prepared, so we're going to go ahead and flip these over because we already know what they are based on the last video. Dirt Tornado was pretty... Actually, both these are really high initiative... Or high initiative here, low initiative here. So we're trying to aim first with the Tinker. The Craig Hart's kind of out of the game, hiding behind a tree, cowarding. He did so much work in the other scenarios, he's just being a wimp this game, ran behind a log and in behind some thorns and is just crying. He's having a rough day. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to get moving on the next scenario here. I just realized that I didn't shuffle the Shaman card, so I'm going to do that now because I'm a horrible person and should be punished. So we're ready to go. We flipped an 18 to 82. We're gonna go ahead and flip our cards. We got a 8. Okay, that's pretty early. Ouch. Then we're gonna go ahead and pull the one for the Vermling Scout. It's a 92. Okay, that's really late. And then a 40 for the Earth Demon. Okay, so interesting. We'll see how this pans out. So Shaman's gonna go first. Thank goodness he's not healing anything this time. He's gonna move. He doesn't need to move because he's right beside me. He's going to attack me. Now, this one's going to attack too, so we might as well start with the Elite first because that's the way it's supposed to work. So he is finally going to go ahead and attack this decoy for the first time ever. So the attack on the Elite, when you're using Elite, it's a 2 to start. There's no extra change, so 2 against is just 2. So 2 damage coming against the Summoning Decoy is enough to kill the decoy as it only has 6 health. So our Tinker Summoning Decoy has finally bit the bucket. And so this guy is no longer on the board, dead, and this damage token's been removed. He is free and clear to go wherever he wants later on. Now this Shaman over here is going to do the same thing. He's focusing on the Tinker, is going to attack as well, and has a chance to immobilize me, which would be really, really bad, because I'm trying to run away, and he's going to stop me from running away, and that's really frustrating. So, holy... Okay, so that's overly aggressive. What? Okay, so that Shaman is a 2. So, or sorry, it's a regular unit. It's attacking me at a 2. Times 2 is 2 damage. Okay, thank goodness it was on that one because it's only 2 damage. Because that could have been so much worse. Okay, so we have to take the damage because I don't want to discard anything. Yikes, okay. Wow, that was bad. And then on the top of it, I'm immobilized, so I can't run anywhere. This game, I tell you, just does not want me to win. It's doing everything it can to just, like, mess with me. Now, we know the Shaman went ahead just now, so what happens on when you're wounded is, unless they heal, he'll take a wound. So this guy here is going to go ahead and take a wound now. So it takes 1 damage because it didn't heal himself. So that goes on number 2, so 1 away from death. But he was still able to go ahead and do the attack against the Tinker regardless. So that's too bad. I am stuck in place. And the Shaman's initiative is done. Now we're going to move to the Tinker. Our whole plan has gone down the toilet because I'm stuck to the ground because of what he just did to me by immobilizing me. And that's going to stay into play until the end of this turn, which is too bad. But what I could do is do some serious damage to one of them and just open the doors up. Now the really bad thing about this is as soon as I kill the Vermling Scout, then the Earth Demon is within range of hitting me. And to be totally honest, I'd much rather have this guy here than the other guy. So what I'm going to do is probably do the stun shot and then maybe do like a... oh, this is ugly. Wow, this really did not go as planned. Anyway, I'm going to do the stun shot first. And I'm going to stun... Who should I stun? The Earth Demon's planning on healing himself. The Scouts are planning on attacking, which is bad. And they're going to melee attack. So yeah, I should stun this guy so he doesn't hit me. So I'm going to go ahead and try to stun him. It's going to be attack with range and a stun on it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's a 0, but at least it gets through on the 1 attack. So 1 damage is going to go against... the scout here, and that's scout number 1. He's going to be stunned, and he'll be stunned until the end of his next turn. So we'll go ahead and find the stun marker, throw that on him. Oh, we got all kinds of these things everywhere now, all over the board. And then that's the end of that card. So that card goes away. So this one here is discarded into the pile. And then we have this one, and we could use it for its attack to blow away, but like I said, there's just no point. Now, the only thing that could be useful in doing this now would be that if I do it now, I can blast away the Shaman particularly and just get rid of him so I don't have to deal with him anymore. But we know that on the next turn, he won't even get to go. He'll die instantly because of the wound. So let's not do that, because it's at the start of your turn that you take a wound or take a damage from being when you're wounded. So let's not actually hit him. Let's maybe let's not waste this card just yet. I'm just going to choose to not do anything and stay still. I'm just going to burn it, essentially. So we're going to put that there, and then that'll be the end of his turn. So now we got to move to who's next. It would be the Earth Demon. The Earth Demon is going to heal, and the Earth Demon heals himself, as it says on the card way up here. The Earth Demon actually doesn't have any damage on him, so that's essentially nothing. And then he consumes any leaf elements, which we don't have, so his turn is null and void and gone. Then we're going to go and move to the next one would be, I guess, the Craigheart. Now, the Craigheart needs to potentially help me out here, so maybe this is where the Craigheart makes a mad dash and tries to do something wild. So with a 4, I could get him to go through the hazardous terrain. Now the hazardous terrain, I think costs, if I just want to double check, I'm pretty sure it costs 2 just to go into it again. No, it doesn't. It's just 1. So I can go through it, which I will, because I'm ridiculous. So 1, 2, 3, 4 will get him here. So that's not bad. And then what he can do is from here, he can actually, so he uses bottom one for 4. He'll use this for the dirt tornado. It'll only be a 1 attack, and it's only going to be able to shoot to here and then hit everything around it. So it will be able to hit him. This is really all he can do. So he's just going to be fodder for this Shaman is all I'm putting him there for, really. And he's going to muddle him, which would be nice. So we're going to go ahead and do attack of dirt of 1, which we know is not going to get through. So it definitely does not get through the shields, but it is going to muddle. So now we get to put an effective muddle onto the Shaman. What the model's going to do is disadvantage him when he tries to attack me on the next turn. So that's a good thing. So again, the Craigheart's doing everything in his power to try to keep me alive. That's wonderful and nice, but still, thanks a lot for nothing, Mr. Craigheart. This time you were useless. So then that is essentially the Craigheart's turn, and then we move to the Scout's turn, I think, is last. The only Scout that's close to me is this Scout, but he's stunned. So his stun marker becomes removed at this point, and is just gone. The other thing that became removed because I was done the Tinker's turn and didn't move was my immobilization token should have come off as well. So this guy ends up doing nothing on his turn, and these two still remain. The poison still remains, so now we're all squared away. And that's essentially it. That's the end of the round. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do a... well, at this point, what ends up happening is... we're done the round, so we're going to wane this thing down, the fire token down to the end. We're going to go ahead and shuffle anything that got a shuffle card, which was a large majority of these cards over here. So a lot of this stuff is going to get flipped, and it's going to get kind of shuffled back into itself, and then cut multiple times. Okay, and then we're going to split it in half, like so. So that one's done. That's for the Vermling Scout. The Earth Demon is going to do the same thing. Doesn't have any damage on him. We're avoiding these guys anyway. We're not trying to actually attack them. The point is to just try to kill them, essentially. And that's that. So, done. All right, the Earth Demon's done. And then we're going to do the modifier for the enemies, because that nice times 2. Still haven't seen the curses or the blessings that were put into our deck from earlier on in the game, but you never know when those might come back. So we'll see. There we go. So that's ready to go. And I think everything's shuffled now. These ones don't need to be shuffled. This doesn't need to be shuffled. And what ends up happening now is when we go ahead to start the next round, is the Craigheart's going to look and sit there and say, well, we can't actually If we short rest right now, we can't play two cards. If we choose to long rest, you have to have at least two cards in your... so essentially, I'll long rest with the Krag Hearts, what I'm going to do. So on his turn, he's going to choose a long rest. The reason I'm doing that is it puts him there as cannon fodder for the Shaman. And then at the very end of the round, he's not going to be able to do anything further. And then essentially he is going to die or become exhausted. So let me just see here. Yes, it's actually been a little bit. So I'm just going to double check on the exhaustion situation. Here we go. So if a character at the beginning of a round, a player cannot... at the beginning of a round, a player cannot play two cards from his or her hand because they have one card or no cards in his hand, and also cannot rest because they have one card or no cards in their discard pile. Okay, so if we go ahead and we rest, it puts us at... yes, that's right. We'd rest and we'd end up losing a card at the end. So we're going to go ahead and long rest with the Krag card. It gives him the longest ability. I just knocked his health out. So that's kind of tragic because I don't remember where it was. I think it was at 6. I just smacked it. But he's not going to make it anyway, so that's okay. Sorry about that, guys. I just smacked the player board. So we're going to move past him. He's just going to sit, put, and long rest. He'll be at initiative 99. The Tinker, on the other hand, is our hero of the day, and he's going to... We've got to split these cards up, and we've got to find a way to lose one. And we also want to survive, and we know we've got a lot of angry individuals who want to see us dead. This is the card we're choosing to lose, which is not bad. Enhancement Field, because we may not need to really do much attack. Oh, sorry, that's the loss. And then he's back and up and ready to go. So we got cards that have lots of movement still. We have like a movement 4. This one has a really nice attack. This one has a heal. So the Tinker has the cards that he needs, and he's even got the ability to loot from a distance. So we've got a chance here, and so we want to make sure in this turn we go super early. We know that the Vermling Scout, who's right here, right now currently has one hit against him. We need two more to be killed. We want to make sure that happens regardless of anything that goes on, because if it doesn't happen, we are going to be regretting pretty much everything that's going on. So we need two damage to at least get through and hit the Vermling Scout. And we want to make sure we go as early as humanly possible. So if we do something like... But we also want to be able to move. So it might be a good combo to do like a Toxic Bolt with a move. That'll give us a 2 attack. And then this... The pulling doesn't make any sense yet. And the Stun Shot doesn't make any sense yet. And it's too much of a gamble with one attack. So this is still a gamble regardless, but we're going to go for it. So that's going to put the Tinker at 18. Okay, so this is where it gets hairy because we have to flip all these. So this is really where it's going to determine what happens. Shaman's at 9. That's really bad because he's right beside us still. Did I end up doing... Yeah, I did my Dirt Tornado attack. Oh, that's right, but he's muddled, so that's good. So he's going to go early, but then he's going to die. Remember, the Shaman's going to die. So regardless, we don't have to worry about the Shaman. He will end up being... He's wounded and he's going to die. The Scouts are going 92. That's great. And then the Earth Demon is going at 40. Okay, perfect. So the Shamans start first. As soon as a Shaman starts his turn, based on the wound, it says as soon as... it says at the start of each of its turns, if a figure is wounded, it suffers 1 point of damage at the start of each of its turns. Continues until it's healed. Well, he never healed himself, so he killed himself. So essentially the wound ended up taking him out and he has died. So that's amazing news, because otherwise we would have had an attack coming behind and hitting the Tinker in the back. So that's an incredible save right there. And so now the Shaman, the only other Shaman that's involved right now is this one. So he's going to obviously focus his attack on the Krag Heart, who's poisoned. He's attacking with a -1, and he's going to go ahead and do that. The attack of the Elite is a 2, -1 is 1, and then he's going to go ahead and do that attack. So we'll see what happens. So -1, so nothing gets through on the Krag Heart, but the Krag Heart is cursed. Normally I would take one of these cursed cards, shuffle it into the deck. I'm not going to bother doing it because he's going to be exhausted on the next turn, at the end of this turn anyway, at the end of the round, it doesn't matter. And sorry, he was poisoned, so it was actually 1 plus the 2, so it was actually, he was at attacking with a 3 minus 1 minus 1, so we actually got 1 damage through, so we'll just knock him down by 1. It doesn't really matter. But either way, cannon fodder, essentially. So that's it for the shaman. Now we're going to move over to the hero, the only one that really matters to see whether something happens in this area over here, and that is the tanker. So the tanker is going to do the toxic bolt attack. He's going to do it against this guy here, who's already got 1 hit on him and only needs 2 more to die. It's going to poison him as well if he survives, and we'll jump up the leaf. So this is where it comes down, guys. This is where it finally comes down. Can we please, for the love, get a positive number? 0. That's okay. We're okay with 0s. That's okay. No, I will take it. I will take it. Okay. So we now have that stun, or that attack 2 came through clean. That's 2 against him. That's the 3 we need. He is now dead. So we've taken this guy out as well. So now we can put another, because there's coins everywhere on this tinker. If you really wanted to be greedy, you could loot all this stuff. So he's gone ahead and killed him. That's great news. No point doing anything else with this top action here except move the leaf to the strong column. This now gets discarded. The tinker is going to run like hell. He does not want to be around this guy at all. So he's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 and get all the way up there. And he's almost within range. And even using our loot too on the next turn, we could risk it and try to grab it, see what happens. So that's that. And then this one gets discarded. Now we move over to the Earth Demon. The Earth Demon's going to heal himself, and then he's going to consume the leaf ability to immobilize all enemies within range 3. Well, the thing is, he's within range 3, we're just outside of range 3. 1, 2, 3. That's incredible. Wow, we played that exactly. Like, if that we had had one less movement on that, he would have immobilized us and we would have been stuck for another turn. And we have 4 cards, but that's still sketchy. So we were able to get outside of that. This actually ends up consuming itself because of the fact that it's a buff that his character just does. So he'll just immobilize any enemy around him for 3, even if it doesn't hit anything. It still consumes it off the chart. So that still happens. He heals himself, but he's not damaged because he has no damage tokens up here at all. And that's it. So that's good. Now the only other problem is the scouts. Now the great thing about this is this guy has not moved. He hasn't got a move keyword. So this scout is jammed behind the obstacle and can't get out to come after me and attack me. So it's wonderful. He's stuck there. He's got nothing he can do. So that's it for the enemy turns. And now we're going to come over to the Craig Herd, who's initiative 99. And it's the end of his turn. So what we're going to do now is he is going to, and it's a long rest. So in order to long rest now, you'd long rest. And he's not going to have 2 cards to play on the next turn, because long resting requires you to toss away one of your cards. Now he's only got 1, so essentially he's exhausted. He is now out of the game. He won't be able to play the next turn, so he's gone. When you become exhausted, your character comes straight off the board, no longer resides there. Doesn't mean we lose. As long as the tinker happens to get an even number on that objective in the back, we still win. If he doesn't and we get an odd number, we most certainly lose. We'll run out of time, our guys will get exhausted, but I'm really hoping that something good will happen. We will see. So that's it. That's essentially all there is for the moment. And so this is a good time to end this video. And then we're going to move into the next video and determine really what's going to happen. But I can tell you right now, we got a good shot to make it there. And we've even still got a 17 for our initiative. That's pretty good. That should put us hopefully ahead of these guys. Even if he has some movement to come running after us, he's pretty slow. So anyway, guys, hope you guys are enjoying. Please subscribe if you like what you see, and I will see you in the next episode as we determine whether or not we find the all-important blood root needed to create the medicine we need to save our friend in the Gloomhaven Kickstarter mini campaign. So until next time, guys, keep rolling solo.